Good morning, everyone. We're here on like call 57, 58, 59. I don't even know. It's 8:24. Excited to have Sir Astley here now teach this advanced training. We were supposed to have this. When we were in the Charlotte launch, we were supposed to have a little bit of time for him and I to do it, but we were just so back to events. We didn't have the time to like load up my laptop. He was going to do my YouTube, but since it's so hard to like control my screen and then in YouTube, it's hard to give your login and password. And so I'm letting him update his, like when he uploads a video, what he does on his hashtags, how he, I mean, maybe you could do an ad or something, sir, like something like that. So like, I've never seen all the stuff you're going to do. So whatever you think you could fit in 30 minutes that people should know about on how to make their YouTube better. Cause I know you guys have started a trend, you and Sean. I see a lot more of our agents putting the YouTubes. Chelsea, I see you doing it every day. Dagmara, I know, is doing it, often. I see her doing her videos. She's crushing it. And a few other agents that I see now taking that wave. And I think, and I'm sure, Ashley, like at the beginning, you know, a lot of times, you know, I look and I always view and I always like, let's just say, but I always see all these YouTubes, you know, like YouTube, not stars, but also, yeah, stars or like people aspiring YouTube that don't lose sight of it. You know, I'm sure, sir, after you went probably how many months are like, man, am I doing this? What am I doing? Is a waste of my time. Mm-hmm. Can you talk a little bit about that before you dive in and screen share? How long did it really take for you to maybe see return on your investment? How many months did you go 5 views, 1 view? Like, could you talk to us a little bit about that?
Yes. You'd go about, well, for me, hopefully we cut your time in half or a third, is about 4 to 5 months where you're not getting the views you want. You're not, but the main thing is you have to stick with it. You don't get enamored by going to Instagram or TikTok because that's instant gratification. Stay with YouTube, continue posting elsewhere, but stay with YouTube because over time, it's a momentum thing. You will get the 50 views, 100 views, and then it's going to get to a few hundred, then it's going to crack 1,000. Just be consistent with it. But it took me about 4 to 5 months to consistently get over, say, 300 views on a video.
Love it. Love it. So, yeah. So actually, I gave screen share a capability. So guys, he's going to, like, as I said a little earlier, if you didn't see, he's going to show how he gets more views in his videos. I mean, I still don't know what he's going to, he's running with this. So, Sir Ash, you got screen share capabilities. I'm here as a student on this one.
Perfect. All right. So I'm switching it up a little bit because I was thinking of our task was what can we do to get George's and Lifestyle's channel in front of the masses, right? But the main thing is whenever you start your channel, you want to do your homework up front. Look at your competition or quote unquote competition. What are successful realtors or whatever you're trying to make a YouTube channel about, what are they doing and how can you duplicate it? There's no need to recreate the wheel, right? You study, do the homework and implement what they're doing with your own twist on it. So as you see here, can you see my screen?
Yeah, we can see it. We can see it.
Okay. So as you see, I have tons of YouTube channels, right? Let's go to the main one. So that's my main one. Yes, I like Rick Ross. All right. So you got the studio background here. And when you start your channel, you may not see all this. I'm trying to see when you first started. That's why I went to the first page. So let's go back. So when you start your channel, you have to start a channel from scratch, create a new channel. Channel name, who wants a YouTube channel? What do you want your name to be?
Speak up, guys, let's do this.
Come on, it's your chance now.
Anybody, give me a YouTube channel, your name and what city you're in.
I got the keys.
Elevate Equity Group in Orlando. Let's go.
All right. Dwayne, you just can look at my channel exactly as far as Charlotte and all that. You said Equity, Orlando, Living, and Orlando. You said Equity Real Estate?
Elevate Equity Group.
Elevate. All right. So you have to figure out, what do you want your channel to be? Do you want to get leads as far as people moving in the area? Do you want to talk to other realtors? Are you trying to recruit? You have to be very particular as far as what you want. So you have that, your channel. And I'll transfer this over to you. Just leave your information in the comments, and I'll transfer this over to you. So settings, this is for, again, beginner, what you need to do. Channel, you have United States. Keywords. What is going to be your keywords? Let's look and see what other channels, because I know there's one, there's Ken somebody living in Orlando.
And question, can you change that after you started the YouTube channel?
Yes, you can change your name. You can definitely change your name. So Ken Pozak, I actually follow him. So I say follow him. You see, I'm not subscribed. Big misnomer. You don't want other real estate agents. I know they're going to follow, right? But you don't want them following your channel, because you're not making the channel for other real estate agents, if you know what I mean. You want your channel to be for your audience. So while I'm all for supporting and sharing other people's content, I will not subscribe to it, because I know that that's not for me. I'm not their demographic. So when you subscribe to other realtor channels, or they're subscribing to your channel as other realtors, it's confusing the algorithm. It's like YouTube is like, do I put it in front of people moving to Orlando or this city, or do I put this in front of other realtors? Does that make sense?
Yes, that's genius. And I'm today years old learning that. So thank you, Sir Ashley.
Sell the sizzle, not the steak, Dana.
You know, that's right.
So living in Orlando, we have Ken Pozak, and he obviously has 40,000 subscribers, right? So he's doing something right. And I use a tool called VID IQ. Yes, I pay for it. If you want to, you can go through every video and search his tags and everything. I like shortcuts. You pay for convenience, right? So these are all his keywords that he uses for his channel. And one of his keywords is my name. We follow each other, I see. Okay. So I'm downloading all his keywords. I'm going to copy all his keywords. Somehow he likes La La Anthony.
What's the program you use for that, Sir Ashley?
VidIQ. So there's different programs. There's VidIQ and TubeBuddy. They do similar things. I like them both for different reasons. And I have them both for different reasons, but you don't need both of them. One would do. And I'm going to ChatGPT just to make this easier for myself. So ChatGPT, I just told them to take all these keywords and separate them with a comma. So that way, YouTube takes the comma as a breaking point when I'm looking at keywords. And it's surprising that his channel is doing so well when his keywords aren't optimized, but we're going to get yours optimized. So we have that. Your channel keywords. You want real estate, that's twice, realtor, filmmaking, breaking news. We don't need that.
So actually, you went fancy. What do you mean? How do you know it's optimized or not?
Yeah, so I looked at all his keywords, right? So these are all his keywords that he used. Now we're looking at Ken Pozak. If I can pull up his thing. So this is all his keywords. Ken Pozak, realtor in Orlando. He has a team of about 20 agents. And he just switched, I think, back to Keller Williams, I believe. He was with Compass, one of the two. But he is the go-to, as far as YouTube goes, for all things Orlando. How do you become the authority figure? Well, you take what he does, put your own spin on it, and do it better. So we searched, based on, I have this thing, we searched his top keywords from VidIQ. That was the CSV file that I got. And I just took, I copied the CSV file and put it into ChatGPT and just asked them to separate it with a comma. Right? Follow me? And so reason why I know it's not optimized, because these are all the keywords. And he wants to be seen as the Orlando expert. Well, I mean, he has Charlotte and C in here. Relationship advice. I mean, maybe, I don't think he talks about relationships on his channel. So how can we, Orlando Living.
You said something about CSV?
Yes, that was just the file that I used to download his keywords. So theoretically, you don't need a file. If you wanted to, you just can copy. You just can cut and paste all of these keywords that he has, but it doesn't always come out clean, if that makes, yeah.
So that's the keywords from another person that's really good in YouTube.
Exactly.
Okay.
And he's very good at YouTube. These are his keywords, but the thing is, his keywords, he wants to be seen for Orlando, but his keywords has Miami in it. Family matters, comedy news, hype plus, like, so just think if his keywords were optimized for his channel, how much bigger he could be.
How do you see the, like, for my YouTube, how can you see my keywords if I'm doing it right?
I will get to you. I will do that. I'll pull that up in 1 second.
Okay.
So moving to Orlando. Give me some suburbs of Orlando.
Winter Park, Winter Garden, Winter Springs is another good one. Oviedo.
All right. So we can add that. You have up to 500 characters. Right now we're at 426. We don't want business advice. We can put Sirhant. I'm not mad at Sirhant because he is a name, right? He's an authority figure in real estate. So I don't mind that. Real estate advisor, real estate broker, entrepreneurship. We're not talking about that. So I would fill that out so we have as close to 500 as possible, right? 500 characters. Upload defaults. This is where you have a generic description that's going to go on all your videos. If you look at his videos, you're going to have something where obviously you don't want to have to put your license number and everything in every video or contact me. You can put that. Obviously, we're going to make it yours, right? But we can put that in every video. That's what's gonna be there. Because you wanna make your uploads as simple as possible. All right. So visibility, I put, when I upload a video, I don't want it to go public right away because I want to make tweaks and changes. So I put private. And then the tags that you're going to use for every video is going to be some of the tags we just did. This is where it gets tricky. All right. So right there, right? So remember, if you see where I'm at, I'm at the side of your YouTube page, you're at settings. This is the backend stuff to get your channel primed for success. You wanna have the foundation right. So when you add videos, YouTube knows who to push it to, as opposed to it just going out there in the ether. Somebody has something to say, I'm sorry.
I muted them.
Okay. So channel, we have that. That's the basic info. Advanced settings. Is your content for kids? No, this is not a kids channel. Auto captions. I'm fine with my inappropriate words if I curse. That's fine.
So actually, when you made your default private, you have to remember to change it to public, or you always keep it private? How do you do it?
Yeah, so my default is always private, simply because when I upload a video, I typically don't want it published right away. Right. So upload it to YouTube, make it private, and then I can do the back end stuff as far as, okay, edit my title, change a little bit of the description. If I want to put different links in there, I can do that. Then schedule it to go public at a certain time, or make it go public right away. But by default, when I upload it, it's private.
And you did that since the beginning, sir, Ashley, like when you had not that many followers?
Yeah. I mean, so it's private. Now it's only private until so let's say you do a video today, right? Do a video this morning and you upload it, it's private. And then you fix out, you rectify any kinks, right? Cause you're like, oh man, maybe I don't like this title, or maybe I need to change this thumbnail, as opposed to the world seeing that you changed the thumbnail before it went public. You get to basically make all the corrections and then make it public to the world. So, and this is VidIQ right here. VidIQ gives you the stats, and TubeBuddy does the same thing. It gives a breakdown for your channel and gives you suggestions on what would be relevant to what your channel is about, and what's the likelihood of people watching, viewing, and all that. Because think about it, YouTube gets paid by engagement and people watching, because they can put ads on it. So the longer they watch your video, the more YouTube would put your video out there. And it gives you stats. Last 7 days, I had 15,000 views. That's up 51%, 100 subscribers. Watch hours, 703 watch hours. That's down. So I haven't been in front of as many people, right? But when you do YouTube right, think about it. How many, I don't know the number to this, somebody with a calculator, how many hours is in a day? 24. What's 24 times 7? So 168 hours in the past 7 days. People, I've been prospecting 703 hours in the past 7 days. So no matter how good you are on the phone or anything like that, you're not going to be on the phone 703 hours in a week. It's just impossible, right? So I have these videos out there prospecting, getting clients for me over and over and over again. And you have retention, 35.8. That is actually, that's decent. It's not great. It is up 1.3%. Revenue is down. I've been putting out more shorts. Shorts is obviously not enough watch time. It doesn't get as many ads. So your revenue's down. And when you get monetized on YouTube, you have to make a conscious decision. Now, monetization requires 4,000 watch hours or 1,000 subscribers. I think it's 500 subscribers now. And it's a gift and a curse, because you go from, at least I can speak from my own personal experience, you go from making content that you believe your prospects would want to see to making content that YouTube is going to promote. Because you're like, okay, prospects, obviously I'm getting clients that way, I'm putting out content, but if I put out what YouTube wants, I get more watch hours, watch time, and I get paid that way. So it's a give and take. I say you gotta walk that line. You have to walk the line. And at times it's tough because you're like, what am I gonna put out? And you're overthinking it. But it says this service, VidIQ, gives you ideas, daily ideas. What would a good video be? Foreign home buyers are bailing the housing market, are bailing on the housing market. So we won't do that. We can do this, George. I looked at Lifestyles page, your page, as far as what our goal is going to be, as far as getting in front of people. And there's a couple competitors, quote unquote competitors, or people that are doing it very well on YouTube that I think we can hijack their content or their content strategy and dominate. So obviously Tom Ferry, I don't know if anybody heard of Mike Sherrard. And then I looked at EXP, and with everybody they have there, they only have 23,000 subscribers. And the last video yesterday put out 265 views, which is anemic for the size of the brokerage and everything like that. So that's something not to follow. You like to follow somebody that's more nimble and knows what they're doing as far as YouTube goes, which is Mike Sherrard, Tom Ferry, and there's somebody else. I like him too. Although his views, he got the same amount of views, but he only has less than 10,000 subscribers. So he's good too. I actually watch him. As you see, I'm subscribed to him. Somebody wanted me to look up their YouTube.
Mine.
What is it?
Mine's is Chelsea Walters Realtor.
That spell it right?
That's me.
Perfect. All right. So, hold on. So first thing I would do is, where are you located? I'll make it clear. Right, it says Miami real estate, but I'll put Miami like front and center, like probably right around here.
In the
on the side, on the left side of where your icon is, where your face is.
Mm-hmm.
To the left side, I'll put like your go-to Miami realtor. So I'm not sure about the rules, or you can't say best, right? But you can say your go-to Miami realtor.
Okay.
Right. To where it's perfectly clear where you're at. What you service, and even in your name, I would say something Miami in there.
Okay.
Because you don't want people guessing, right? Not until you have like a following and you're known for something. Because if you look back at my channel, like right now it's Real Estate Advisor Sir Ashley, but for the longest, and anybody is, I'm sure Sean, he probably watched and saw me change it. It was Charlotte Living, your Charlotte real estate agent, or something like that with Charlotte. And then it went to North Carolina, and then it just became Real Estate Advisor, right? So that's that. And so you don't, how many videos do you have? People need to realize thumbnails matter. think about it. I mean, you don't say don't judge a book by its cover, but you're competing for attention in YouTube, right? So what I would do is, it says new property alert in Miami, talking about your last video 2 months ago, right? As opposed to it being you, it should be a big, big photo about the curse, a big photo of the property, right? With arrows pointing to it, to where you're drawing attention to what the video is about, as opposed to, I mean, if they wanted to see that picture of you, they just look at the main page. Right? So let's click on the video. And as opposed to, trying to see all my tools here. So if I'm looking correctly, you don't have any description to the video.
Okay.
Right? So again, you need to let YouTube know what this video is about and who it's for. Yes, they can do, they're going to transcribe the video. YouTube transcribes every video, because if you look at it, let's put it on mute, but if you look at it, there's closed captions for it. Even though you didn't add the closed captions or anything like that, YouTube was music. Are you speaking at all in this video? No. All right. So missed opportunity is these videos obviously work for listing presentations and on MLS and stuff like that. But for YouTube, you want to put a voiceover, because YouTube is going to take the audio and figure out, where does this go? Where does this belong? So between the fact that you don't have any audio, they can't use your words, and you don't have a description, as far as they can't be like, okay, well, this is Miami real estate, in the description and what it's about, what area and everything like that, they don't know who to give it to. They don't know who to put it in front of, because YouTube wants to put valuable content in front of. You ever go on your YouTube page and wonder like, man, how do they know I like this stuff? Because they study what you like, and based on their AI and their algorithm, they're going to feed you what they think you like based on the audio, the transcript of the video, and the tags, the description. But without any of that, you just had, I'm not going to say they're all family members and realtors, but you just have family members and realtors watch it, right? So you want to be rewarded for your work. Just put a voiceover over it, and you don't have to be crazy with the voiceover as far as the description. You can literally take this transcription of whatever you're saying and put it in the description. There is a tool. I know we're over time, but there's a tool here. This one isn't going to be one. Hold on. All right. So you're talking here. Perfect. All right. So Coconut Creek open house. You want to be a little bit more engaging with your title. Title and thumbnails matter. You want to be like be descriptive regarding the open house or the title or the house. Like, what about it pops, right? And for what it's worth, don't take this the wrong way, but no one cares that you're in it, right? You only have 100 characters for your description. You don't need to use all of them, but you want to make the ones you use work, right? Now, if you're Ryan Serhant, by all means do it. But he doesn't do it. Like, he might have like maybe 5 words in his title. It's one of those things to where you want your words to matter. And there's a way in which you can do it. VID IQ. Look at your competitors. I pulled these up from, again, I thought we were going over George's. So that's not it. Keywords. No. keywords you can use. These are related keywords to move into Miami. You don't need to, again, recreate the wheel. These are highly competitive ones. That means people are paying for them with Google Ads and they're searched often. So I would copy all of the, except, you know, TikTok and all that stuff, World Tour, any ones that have to do with Miami and that could pertain to your real estate business, I would copy it, put it into the description of the video or the tags in the video. And then this also gives you suggestions on what you should write, make a video about. Because we like to talk about houses and house tours and all that, which is fine and dandy, right? But people moving to Miami or moving within Miami want to know, what is it like living in Miami in your 20s? What is it like living in Miami in your 30s? Right? You want to give them stuff that's relatable as opposed to stuff that we want to see. Nobody cares what we as realtors want to see. And that's where we get it mixed up at. We have to really think about the consumer and what are they searching and how can we get in front of them. Now, I can talk about YouTube all day. So I know we're over time.
So Ashley, yes. The length of the video, how long or how short can these videos be?
Speak on that? So if you do, one thing I'm playing around with now is the length of my video. Obviously, YouTube, their new toy, their new baby is the reels or the shorts, YouTube shorts. So what I've been trying to do is give them a short every single day because it's their new thing, like anything. When you get something new, you want to play with it and promote it. So by all means, do the YouTube shorts. Those are less than 60 seconds or 60 seconds or less. But for long form content, to be the expert, if you look at Ken Pozak and all that, you want your video to be no less than 6 minutes, but to be able to, I like to, again, you come across, when you get monetized, you get jaded a little bit. So I try not to make my video less than 8 minutes personally, because at the 8 minute mark, I can put ads in my video every 2 to 3 minutes. And I get paid every time somebody goes and watches an ad. But I say no less than, if you're doing a long form video where it's the, you know, the YouTube format, the traditional YouTube format, I say 6 minutes. Now, if you don't have 6 minutes worth of content, by all means, don't just drag it out, right? I'd much rather watch a 4 minute video that is bang, 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 as opposed to somebody just dragging it out just to get to 6 minutes or 8 minutes.
And I know that YouTube is different than other social media sites. Do you put captions on yours?
No, because YouTube already creates the captions.
Okay.
Right? I don't put captions on it. YouTube already creates it. And what I end up doing, this is where I'll tell you my strategy. I'd make the long form YouTube video, right? 6 to 8 minutes. My last one, I think, was like 11. I drug it out, not going to lie. I take the link to that video and upload it into a software. There's a few of them. video.ai, and it makes it into reels. So as opposed to having to create multiple reels, they just take 30 to 45 second clips of that long form video, and then I just repurpose it in other platforms and on YouTube shorts. The biggest thing is we want to talk about what our clients are looking for or our potential clients are looking for, as opposed to due diligence or earnest money deposit. Or we can get there, right? But we need to teach YouTube and Google, because owned by Google, who our audience is. And our audience is, at least for me, people moving to the Carolinas. That's my audience. So if you look at my videos, that's where I started off, right? And then once you have that, then I can go into educating and go into as far as the real estate housing market and stuff like that, because they're being shown to people that are interested in the Carolinas.
Can you tell me how long it takes you? I mean, at this point, you probably got the whole thing down, you know, down back. But how long did it take you in the beginning to get this whole system down? Because it sounds like it takes forever. Am I wrong?
So no, you're not wrong at all. It's a learning process because YouTube, like any platform, changes periodically. Like just this past summer, they changed the monetization schedule and they got a new toy earlier this year with the shorts. So now they're promoting that and not really promoting the long-term form video as much. So it's a learning process, but trust me, it is well worth it. I spend money on leads now, but I don't have to. YouTube allows me to reinvest in my business without any outside leads or anything like that. I know I'm going to get anywhere from 5 to 10 leads a day. Now, are those leads going to be slam dunks? No. Well, but two of them probably will be if it's 10, right? It's going to be like 20 to 30%. So I'll rather be at bat those 10 times and get the 20 to 30% as opposed to not seeing me or knowing me, right?
And the leads in YouTube are different because it's not like there's a call to action button, is there? Like how do they reach out to you?
So we talked about her page, right? So this is, talked about her page. I'll put go to Miami Realtor on one side. On the other side, I would put call me with your phone number or schedule a consultation. And you could put links down here. I don't know if you can see my screen, but you can put links down here to where you can go to your Calendarly, your link tree, whatever it is. You can put links down here for people to reach out to you. But make it simple. Call me with your number. Yes, you're putting your number on YouTube. If you don't want people to call you, I mean, I'm sorry, right? We want our phone to ring. It may be annoying at times because, like, trust me, I get calls at 11. I don't get calls past 11 pretty much right now, but 11, it gets annoying. But I'd much rather them call me than not call me.
And you have a tracking number so you know it's from YouTube or not?
No. I just really put my business cell phone on there.
Okay. I appreciate it. I saw you smiling. I'm sorry you had to give that secret sauce, but I appreciate it.
No. You're good. You're good. No, it's one of those things to where I like going deep into YouTube and how to make it work. And any questions you have, like, I'm an open book because I understand that it is a different language and it takes a while to learn it. And if you don't stay on top of it, you're going to get left behind too. So I'm telling you what works now, but in a year, it may be slightly different. And you might be wondering, okay, why am I not getting as much traction? Right? You just got to stay on top of it.
Question. What would you put on their handle, on their channel customization? What is that?
Yeah, well done. Where are we at?
Channel customization. Close there, it's on the side.
Yeah, right here?
Below earn.
Below earn, I'm sorry, customization, yeah. Okay. Yep, I'm sorry. Branding, so this right here, so I'll get to what you asked for. Let's just go to that real quick. This right here is where you upload like your face or whatever it may be. That's what's going to be seen as your channel picture, your profile picture. Most people put their face. And then here is that banner that I was talking about. You can go to Canva and create a YouTube banner to where, yes, you want your face on there, but you want calls to action. Your go-to Miami Realtor. Call me. Schedule a consultation with arrows pointing to the links that you can put, right? And then I even, for the watermark, you can put your phone number. There's this realtor in Charlotte for their watermark. They literally have their phone number. So handle is whatever you want. I will put, if it was me for this one, living in Orlando, - my name. Or - real estate agent, my name, right? then description, tell people, YouTube mainly, who your channel is for. Hey, on this channel, you'll learn the ins and outs of the greater Orlando area, for all the insights regarding where to eat, work, play, sleep, follow me, right? So you want to make it clear, like, this is what my channel is about. And then your external links right here, as far as your, again, your website, your Calendarly, various things like that. You can add all that right here as well.
Perfect. Thank you so much.
No, you're welcome.
Sir, sir, quick question. This is Joe Almeida from Myers. VidIQ now has AI built into it, right?
Yes, yes.
So what has been your experience with the content ideas that that gives you? Have you tried that out at all?
Yeah, I've tried it out. Again, so my hesitation is they give you good content ideas, right? As far as what's gathering views or what's garnering views. But then that's where you have to be selective, because I'm not gonna lie. Sometimes I follow their content ideas because that's what the general public wants. But is that going to further my real estate business for the Carolinas?
Right.
It's right. One of those things to where you have to realize that I was talking to two people recently about this. Your most impactful video may not be the video with thousands of views. It may be that video that is to that small subsection of people, but they watch it and they're going to start quoting that video to you, like what you said. And you're like, man, I didn't think anybody even liked this video, but you're talking to a particular subsection. So it's one, it's really is, it's like a ego boost now because you got thousands of views, or the long-term play to where you're talking to a dedicated group of people.
So you're better off researching what's being searched on YouTube related to your topic and your area, yourself.
Exactly, your area, yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Because you want to be the local celebrity, the local mayor, right? Now, yes, it's nice to be known on the YouTube world for everyone, everywhere in the country. But again, this is a lead generation. So it does no good if people in California sees me and love me as a realtor if I'm not getting in front of the Carolina people.
Mm-hmm. Yep, makes sense.
And hey, listen, sir, we went into 45 minutes. guys, yeah. Sir, man, thank you, man. Like, these are things, like, this is good because it's timeless. We still got to do mine, but bro, thank you for taking the time this AM. Everybody on here, we got like 70-80 people on here. Let's rock and roll. Sir, I'm going to give you a call a little bit late. Oh, actually, let me stop the recording here. Oh, no, it's recording. Oh, recording. Stop. Oh, we got to send.